Welcome to my channel on numerical methods in civil engineering. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest update. Okay, so let me continue with Simpson's rules. I will start with Simpson's rule today. So yesterday we were doing triangular problem. Okay, triangular load problem. This one. Okay, the connection has cut. Actually, I was explaining the Excel, solving the problem by Excel. So final answer you'll get it as 5370 something. Okay, so today at the end of the class I'll be explaining how to do the problem with Excel, and so same thing you'll have to repeat for the assignment problems I'm going to give you. Okay, you need to submit this problem, one problem each person. Okay, for each method I'll let you know how many. I'll be giving different questions to everyone. Okay, so let me start with the Simpson's rule now today. So the Simpson's rule is nothing but, as I told you, it was named after Thomas Simpson. Its strength is that although the rectangles and trapezoids work better for linear functions, Simpson's rule works quite well on curves. Okay, it's the trapezoidal rule works for straight line portions. Okay, whereas Simpson's rule work for the curved portions. As you can see in the previous problem, here you can get the curve region. Okay, in this kind of complex problems, there'll be curved regions and straight line regions, again curved regions. Okay, so this is curved region on the right hand side, from here to here also curved region. So if you have curves, so since you'll be using the straight lines for joining the points, so the results will be accurate if you are using trapezoidal method. So this Simpson's rule, it is little accurate than trapezoidal rule. So in the Simpson's rule, this will be work properly for the areas which are having the curves. Okay, and Simpson's rule works based on the three points. You can find the equations of quadratic through those points. Now let us assume three points. That's nothing but these are the three points: 3, 12, and 1, 5, and 5, 9. So let us start with the 3, 12. Okay, and if you substitute the value of that in quadratic equation, that's nothing but ax square plus bx plus c. So what actually happens, you will get an equation in terms of abc. Similarly, if you do it for the other two points, that's nothing but 1, 5 and 5, 9, you'll get other two equations. These are the other two equations. This is the first equation, other two equations. Now if you solve these three equations, you will get the values of ABC. So those are ABC are nothing but 1.25, 8.5 and minus 2.5. Okay, so these are the values. Now if you substitute that in the y equation, okay, that's nothing but y is equal to x square plus bx plus c. If you substitute the value of ABC, the final equation will become this. That's nothing but y is equal to minus 1.25 x square plus 8.5 x minus 2.25. Okay, this can be better illustrated by having one Excel sheet. Let me just take an Excel sheet. So I'll just take x points and y points, x and y. So the first x point was 3, 12, and then what are those values? Yeah, 3, 12, x is 3 and y is 12, and then again x is 1 and x 1 and 5, and then you have 5, 9. So if you join those, if you draw a chart, actually you will get it can be vice versa, 1, 5, 1, 3, 5 also you can have it. So insert, so here 1, 1, 5, 1, 3, 5 will have to have. Yeah, we'll just, because it should be in increasing order. 1, 3, 5. Let these be some points on the this thing. So now we'll insert a scatter plot. Insert plot scatter. So we'll get a curve like this. Okay. So this is the curve. That is what it is being given here. So now if I actually, you know, as here we have solved. Okay. So this is how you can use, you have three equations and you can find ABC values by some means. Okay. You can also use the numerical method as well. So if I draw that, I mean, so the other way is you can just execute those points like this. Okay. At trend line, if you consider, and if you give two, order two, and if you display equation, you can see the same values. Okay. You can get the same 1.25, minus 1.25, 8.5 and minus 2.5, which are same as this, isn't it? Can you see this? Yeah. Anybody? Hello. Anybody? Just reply. Are you able to see these values?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So,
yes, sir.
If you do manually also, you will get the same values. Okay. You can just use three equations linearly. Okay. If you simplify one by one, you will get A, B, C. As these, A is equal to this, B is equal to C, this, and C is equal to this. Or you can use this Excel method. So I've just, taken the, the points in order. 1, 5 is this point, 3, 12 is this point, 5, 9 is this point. And then if I add a trend line and I could get an equation. So this is the equation. So that means if you have any curve, so you can fit it by some parabola equation. Okay. And then there is a formula for finding out the area of this parabola, which are having three ordinates, one this ordinate and this ordinate, which I'm going to explain now. So once if you have an equation, okay, with all the values of ABC, right? So that's nothing but P of X. F of X is the given problem, okay? F of X will be given problem and that will have different shape, okay? But now what you should do, you need to get some equation, okay, with the ABC known and keep it ready and plot that one. Then the area of that, okay, can be obtained by this his Simpson rule, okay? You can use the Simpson's rule for finding the, this shape, okay, where you will have, so if you can, let us consider for that. Let me explain the Simpson's rule with example. Step by step Simpson's rule. Now, let us consider there is some arbitrary area, or we know which can be, you can consider it as a some complex area where you have the curve region like this over here. You have a very curvy portion here. So you can see this is curve. Okay, it is also curve like this. It is going like this. Okay. So in such the case of curves, if you use a trapezoidal rule, what actually happens, you will be assuming these are the straight lines, okay? So you will be assuming these are straight lines, just like this, okay? Will be approximating the area calculation. So here, there will be some gap which will be there between them, and which will give you some error, okay? So here, even if you consider here, there is some gap. We use straight lines. So alternatively, some improved method you can adopt is the Simpson's rule. In Simpson's rule, what actually it will be done is you will be considering three ordinate ones. Okay, three ordinate ones like this. So if you consider area now, you will consider first three ordinates. These are the three ordinates. Okay. And what you will do with the y1, y0, y1 and y2 and x values. So there will be x interval, right? So there will be h as the interval. So there will be two intervals. Now the coordinates for this will become 0, y0. And here this coordinates will become h, y1. And this coordinates will become 2h, y2. All of you can get it, right? So this is 0 comma y naught, right? And this one will be h comma y1, and here this ordinate will be 2h comma y2. So you will have three sets of points. So same thing which will be explained over here. So we'll have three sets of problem values. This will be y0, y1, and this will be y2, and these intervals will be, you will have h as this and another h. So therefore the ordinates over here, it will be you know, if you start from here origin, so this will be 0 comma h, sorry, 0 comma y0, and this one will be h comma y1, and this point will be 2h comma y2. Therefore you will have three sets of points which I have explained earlier, and you can get a fit, you can fit the parabola, okay, between these points. But actual curve may be a little different, but what we will be doing is you will be assuming some curve. But what actually you will be doing in trapezoid is, I'll just show you with some blue color. What actually, some other color, I'll just take it. Maybe purple I'll take. So what actually you'll be doing in, you know, trapezoidal rule is, you'll be considering them as a straight portions like this, one straight line and other straight line like this. And you can see the error if you have, if you use that trapezoidal will be more, because see, gap is very more. But if you use Simpson's rule, the error will be reducing, because almost it's a curve, and it's almost nearest to the actual curve. Okay, so more the steeper the curve, more the error will be in trapezoidal rule. But that can be reduced in by using Simpson's rule. So Simpson's rules, what you will be doing, you will be using some parabola to approximate the given curve. So that's how we will solve the calculate the area. So now I'll explain. Okay. So similarly, what you'll be doing is, you will be starting with you know, we'll be splitting the given area into number of many simple areas like this. Okay. So this given area can be split into one area. Okay. Second area. Third area. And fourth area like this. Okay, so there'll be four areas you'll be considering, and so you'll be calculating the area of each by different rules. Okay, who is plotting there? Okay, don't do it. Okay, da1, da2, da3 and da4, so let us consider them as the areas. Okay, so the Simpson's rule can be, so there is only 10 minutes more which we have. Okay, so I'll just complete. So in case of Simpson's rule, what you'll be doing, each group of area can be calculated by this formula. So this is the Simpson's rule. The area of two intervals will be h by 3 y naught plus 4 y1 plus y2. Okay, so this is how you can calculate the area of one particular group of elements. Okay, similarly you can find out the second area, okay, this one from y2 to y4, and the third area from y4 to y6, okay, and fourth area from y6 to y8. So this is the second area, da2 is equal to y2 to y4. Thing is, you should make out the thing here, h by 3 y2 plus 4 y1, oh, sorry, 4 y3. Whichever is the center ordinate, it will have four times, four multiplied with that, okay? And the last and first two terms, first and the last term will not have any multiplication factor. So similarly, you will calculate all the areas. Then what you will be doing is, finally, you will adding the all the areas, and which you will be getting this formula. You will be getting, this is the formula which you're going to get. So that's nothing but h by 3, y naught. So y naught plus 2y2, because 2y2 is because in first area you have one y2 and the second area you have another y2, therefore 2y2 and 4y3 you will have it, and then 2y4, okay, because you will have y4 in this one, and da3 also will have y4, so therefore 2y4 and then 4y5, 2y6, so all the at, I mean, all the even terms, I mean, add terms will have 4, all the even terms will have 2. That means you need to actually start from 0. Okay, 0, 1 first ordinate, second ordinate, third ordinate, so on. So then first and the last ordinate will be multiplied by 1. Second ordinate, that's nothing but second y1 will be multiplied by 4, and then y2 will be multiplied by 2, and similarly it will be carried on. So this is how you will get the total area of the given figure. Okay, so now let us take one simple problem. Okay, application of the Simpson's rule. Okay, so in this Simpson's rule, what you will be doing is, as we had done in case of a trapezoidal rule, same way you will calculate the reactions, and also we will find out the bending moment at x. Let us consider section xx in the given problem. Okay, so now let us take a example as simply supported beam with a UVL. Okay, and they were asked to find out the areas at an interval of L by 8 and to find the total area of the bending moment diagram. They have asked to find out the bending moment. That is, if I read it again, find the area of the bending moment diagram for the simply supported beam loaded as shown in the figure for L by 8 interval. Okay, so the length of the this is actually a general problem. Okay, the length is considered as L, and the intensity of UDL given, I mean UVL at the center is given as Q. So we know, we have already I've explained in the last class, total load of this triangular portion will be, so if Q is the center intensity, QL by 2 will be the center intensity. Okay, so remaining time we have 6 minutes. Okay, let me complete it quickly. And the reaction is QL by 4. Okay, here is the reaction, and you will get it by symmetry. So QL by 4 is the QL by 2 is the total load divided by 2. If you do it, QL by 4, that we have it. And then moment at xx can be obtained by, as I was mentioning in the last class, so reaction R into x, that's nothing but QL by 4 into x minus that's nothing but half into, that's area the ordinate over here is, as I've already explained in the last class, 2wx divided by L I was mentioning in the last class, right? Since here it is Q, so 2qx divided by L is the ordinate over here. Therefore, the area of this smaller triangle will be half into this ordinate, which is nothing but 2qx by L. Okay, that is the total area. That you will be getting. Okay, and into x by 3. So x is the distance. Okay, actually 2q by L actually. And here you will have one more load, which is nothing but x by 3. So the distance from here to here will be x by 3. So QLX by 4 minus half into 2QX divided by L into x by 3. Okay, that is the formula for the moment at x axis. Actually speaking, you will have one more x here. Okay, into x you will get it. Into into x will be there, because 2QX divided by L into x will be there. So finally you will get an equation like this, QL square into 1 by 4 x by L minus 1/3 of x cube divided by L. This is the bending moment equation. So then what you should do, you can just substitute the value of x as L by 8. Okay, so L by 8, and then next interval will be plus L by 8, 2 L by 8, that means L by 4, and then L by 2. Just like that, you can go on calculating the values of, substituting the value of interval as h value, and you will be getting the moments. Okay, m0 is equal to 0, m1 will become, that is nothing but L by 8, this is the L by 8 value. Okay, 1 by 8, and the next interval will be 2 by 8, 3 by 8, 4 by 8. So something like that, you can go on calculating the values till 8 intervals, last value. So the last value will become 0. Next, using Simpson's rule, what you need to do is, so this is m0, you will be having here. So m0, what the equation will be, So you know that the equation, the area equation by Simpson's rule, area A is equal to h by 3, okay, h by 3 into m naught plus, what's the equation? 4 m1, okay, plus 2 m2, okay, plus 4 m3, and plus 2 m5, just like that, so on. It will be continued up to m8, and the last value will be m8, and before that you will have m7. M7 will have 2 m7. Before that you will have this is m4, 2 m4, okay, so just like that, plus m8 plus 4 times m7, just like that it will be continued. So if you just substitute all of them, finally the value of area you will be getting is equal to 0.05025 into QL cube. Okay, so this is how you can calculate area by Simpson's rule. Actually, I have only 2 minutes left. I thought of discussing one more problem here. So better what I'll do, I'll just show you how. I think for that also the time is not permitting, so let me stop here. So any doubt, anybody? Hello, reply me please.
Yes sir.
So you are clear, right? Simpson's rule.
Yes sir. Yes sir.
And I just, okay, making use of this 1 minute, let me explain. As I've already to I was explaining in the beginning, so this Simpson's rule is applicable for the areas where you have curved regions. Okay, so in this problem, you know, in these two problems, you can see actually you can make use of in some problems where you have both curves and straight lines, you can make use of both Simpson's rule as well as trapezoidal rule. In combination of that, you can find out accurately area accurately, because we have a, you know, a completely curve like this in case of in case of triangular load where you have a complete curve portion, you can make use of the Simpson's rule. And whereas here, if you have both the kind of curves, like here it is a curve portion and here it is a straight line portion and here a curve, you can make use of the combination of the curves as well as the straight line. So here it is a Simpson's rule from here to here, and from here to here it will be straight line, I mean trapezoidal rule, again Simpson's rule. Okay, so that's how you should apply a combination of both the methods. I think time is over. Okay, any doubt? Thanks for watching. Like, share, subscribe, press bell button for latest updates.